when I think about the life of Esther and I look at her story from beginning to end, I can't help but wonder what she was made of, you know, what was on the inside of her that caused her to become the woman that she became. She was orphaned as a child, lost mom and dad, and she's being raised by her uncle. And then, you know, these pivotal points in life where you feel like everything's going one direction. I think a lot of us can identify with that. And then out of her control, she's ripped away from everything that is normal and familiar. And she is told, you're now gonna have a different life. You know, she wasn't asked, she wasn't given any options. She was just told, this is what you're gonna do. But when we're reading her story and we see her responses to what's taking place, you have to wonder, what caused her to be chosen? What was that thing? What done this? And I think the easy answer is to say that because God wanted it, and because God wanted it, it happened. And I agree with that. At the same time, Esther found some type of inner strength that was needed to make this happen, to make this work. Not knowing the future, not understanding why anything was taking place, not having the why, not having the answers to her questions, she had to make some type of decision. You know, to get to a point where you say, if I perish, I perish. That took something inside of her. That took something for that day to happen the way that it did. And it didn't come in just that moment's time. I believe something was already in her before she was ever chosen as the queen. Something was already there. So what was that? What was that inner strength? Where did it come from? How did she get it? And can we have it? Although all of her choices and options were taken away from her, there was one that was not. She gave God a gift. The most precious, valuable, most sought after gift that God would want. And she made the choice to give it to him. And I believe it made the difference in everything that happened to Esther from beginning to end. And that is what I want to talk to you about at Esther Conference, August the 24th and the 25th. I will be ministering on Friday night, and I hope that I will see you there.